Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, the number one YouTube channel dedicated to 360 virtual reality filmmaking for everyone. Today, we are going to review a brand new 360 camera, the Labpano Pilot One, as you just saw from the cinematic intro. This is the smallest and lightest four-lens 360 camera that can shoot up to 8K monoscopic 360 video. It is the only 360 camera that can livestream 8K without the need for an expensive PC computer and stitch on the cloud using the new 5G network or Ethernet. And you can fly your livestream camera with real-time 9-axis stabilization on a 5G network. It is a Google Street View ready camera and built for virtual tour creators that hate computer and post-production. You can capture and upload to Google Street View or their cloud-based virtual tour creator directly and see the result immediately. If you are impatient, hate computers, hate stitching, and taking thousands of photos for your virtual tour within a couple hours, this is the camera for you. Since the quick and easy virtual tour is the biggest selling point of this camera, let me start from there. So now I'm gonna show you how ridiculously easy to create a virtual tour with this brand new camera, the Pilot One. So go ahead and hit camera. And then right here it's already in virtual tour, but if you're not, you go ahead and scroll here and select the Pilot Tour. Hit that screen, confirm that. And go ahead and hit the gear icon. And we're gonna choose 8K right here because we can. And then the countdown because we need to hide somewhere, so we need to have a countdown. So 5 seconds should be a good countdown. And then in here in the pro version, you can adjust all the settings like ISO, EV, white balance, all the great stuff. We're gonna just use all those. But we gotta turn on HDR because HDR look better in virtual tour. So turn on HDR. So that's it. So now I'm gonna hit the capture button. I'm gonna type in my name. Let's just say something random. GG. Start tour. And then we'll just give you some instructions to like how to move your camera. Yeah, ignore that. You know that. So go ahead and hit the shutter button. Now countdown, let's go high. As you hit the shutter button, take 3 photos for the HDR. So let's run back. Okay, photo 1 is done. Let's move it. The next spot, which is right here. We gotta do the same thing. Hit the shutter button, let's go run high. Let's hide right here this time. So now we finished the tour, so go ahead, just hit this button. Stop the tour. And that's done. And then, right now, I took a lot of pictures, right? We go to gallery. And then that's the tour we just did, 16 photos. We gotta hit that. I'm gonna hit upload. We gotta upload Pilot Tour right here. Hit this icon. Just hit upload. So after a couple minutes, the tour is already uploaded on the server. Right here, this is my account. You can go ahead and look at view. And you see a 360 virtual tour. Look at that. Then you can hit navigate around. Me right here. Great. Go back. And all this hotspot is auto-generated. I did not do anything. It generated in the camera. We hit right here, see it go to a different spot. Welcome me. Come back here. We go to here. Here, back to the original spot. So sometimes it does make some mistake, like as you see right here, if you click here, it's supposed to go out of the house, but instead it go into the house. Because I actually missing a photo right there. But as you see, this is very easy. It literally took me like less than half an hour and this tour.
Okay, Hugh, come on. Let's cut through the marketing hype. Give us the real deal.
Thank you, stock footage girl. So let me start from the get-go and tell you this is not for consumers. If you can't make money off your 360 camera or services, then this camera is not for you. If you are only using a 360 camera for reframing and action sports, you can skip this video and rewatch my Qoocam AK review, which is a consumer level AK 360 camera that does not cost $1,000. Yes, the biggest disadvantage of Pilot One, it is the price. It costs $1,200 for 64GB memory and $1,250 for 128GB memory. It is almost triple the price of any consumer action 360 cameras. Your wife, girlfriend, or boyfriend will not be pleased if you get this instead of their Valentine's presents. If you are making money with 360 technology, neither virtual tour, video creation, or live streaming, let's look at the spec together. This is a lot smaller than Zcam S1. It only weighs 288 grand. As you see right here, I'm flying it with my consumer Mavic Pro 2 with a vibration isolator. A little drift as it is a windy day, but it totally flies. This is a great camera to fly with DJI Inspire if you want 8K video with built-in stabilization. But it is still heavier than Qoocam AK, Insta360 ONE R, and GoPro Max. So this is definitely not an action camera. Also, not a pocket-sized camera as well, unless you have a really big pocket. If you are familiar with their Gen 1 version, the Pilot Era, right here, the spec is identical. So go watch it now and see the image quality in a 360 video. The same problem in Pilot 1 is frame rate. The 8K is 24 frames per second instead of 30 frames per second, which is unwatchable in a VR headset. You need minimum 30 frames per second and actually prefer to have 60 frames per second for VR headset. So practically speaking, you only have 6K 30 frames per second, which this camera can also do. I don't want to bore you with all the numbers, so check all the spec resolution in both video and photo in the description down below. The touchscreen of this thing is amazing. It's 2.2-inch touchscreen and full Android Open OS. If you like an expensive phone, I never had the need to use my phone to control the camera. Compared to ONE R and GoPro Max, this is refreshing. The camera has onboard powerful CPU and GPU, so it can stitch 8K video internally. There is no need for computer stitching to compare to Qoocam AK, but it's only give you H.264 MP4, not even H.265 with a pretty low bitrate and compressed video. So it is a trade-off. Also, I like that you don't need your phone for stitching like GoPro Max or ONE R. So if you are a professional, it looks pretty good on set, not messing around with your phone in front of the clients. Okay, let's see some footage and do some image quality comparison. Before I show you the footage, just want to make a disclaimer. This is a production unit, but the firmware is still in beta. So the image quality will be improved, but I like to show then tell. So I'm just going to show you the result. Here I'm at the YouTube Space Los Angeles and check out the helicopter. Pretty cool, huh? This is a 4K reframe from an 8K 24 frames per second video. The quality is pretty good compared to ONE R or ONE X. The advantage of having 8K footage. As you know, if you want to get 4K flat video from a GoPro Max or ONE R, you are upscaling your video. But from an 8K source, you are not really. If you follow me around, you will see some stitching issues. This camera has a stitch calibration from 2 meters to infinite. But you need to set it before you film. This requires some professional experience to nail down the stitch distance. As you clearly see right here, your boy fails epically. So, this is another thing that if you come from a two lens world, having four lens and four stitch line are a lot to deal with. Another reason why this is not for everyday users. Let's compare it with Insta360 ONE R and Qoocam 8K. So, it is obvious in 100% scale, Pilot One and Qoocam 8K are larger and clearer than ONE R, which is only 5.7K. But if you turn to the shadows and highlights, ONE R and Qoocam 8K has a much better dynamic range. There is no flat or log mode in the Pilot One, and the dynamic range is bad. I hope they can fix that. It is unfair to compare 5.7K video to an 8K video, so I take out ONE R and just look at Qoocam 8K and Pilot One. So Qoocam 8K has a bigger sensor and 10-bit color depth. Pilot One only has 1 over 2.5 inches sensor. It's a small Sony sensor, but it has four of them and four lenses, double the number of Qoocam 8K. It is only 8-bit though. So, is number better than size? If you zoom in, it is not. Sensor size does matter.
That's what she said.
As you see, Qoocam 8K looks sharper and has a more detail, even though it's slightly noisier. The Pilot One also looks a lot more compressed compared to Qoocam 8K. Pure image quality, Qoocam 8K is still better 8K than Pilot One. Okay, how about stabilization? Labpano Pilot One has what they call Pilot Steady, which is a 9-axis gyroscopic stabilization, just like the Insta360 Pro 2. And here is my one real stabilization test. As you see, even I cut through the grass, which is very bumpy, the stabilization is still pretty decent. There are some nasty compression artifacts in the sky, as you see right here, when the camera is moving. I hope they can fix that. Let's compare it with Qoocam 8K. So why now we rig together the Qoocam 8K and the Pilot One, and we're gonna do some running stabilization tests. Let's do it now. As you see, Qoocam 8K is a lot more steady. It handles really well against all the jumps and shakes I did with the cameras. Funny thing is, if you compare Qoocam 8K with my GoPro Heroes 8, which is the tiny screen in the middle, Qoocam 8K is even better than GoPro. So again, it is a great example to show that 360 camera is a lot more stable than 2D cameras in general. How about 360 photos? Here is a Pilot One regular photo, and here is an HDR photo. The HDR photo looks a lot better, but still, we see lens flare right here. Pilot One takes 8K photo, that is 8192 by 4096, the bigger 8K, not the 8K UHD. So it is a lot bigger photo than Ricoh Theta Z1. But how is the quality compared to the king of 360 photo camera, the Z1? Well, here is the side-by-side comparison. The Z1 has better color and no lens flare. Let's look at the chart together. Z1 has a better dynamic range as well. Let's punch it 200%. Z1 is noisier, but if you look at the wood panels or the car in the distance, Z1 clearly has more details than Pilot One. So again, sensor size does matter.
At least we put this matter to bed. That's what she said. Or he said.
Although Pilot One has a way faster workflow than Z1 or Qoocam 8K, it can directly color grade within the camera itself, as you see right here. You can change your gamma, exposure, highlights, and shadow. you don't really need to transfer your photo to your phone with a different apps like Snapseed or Theta Plus, and can directly upload your photo inside the camera, which is a lot faster. HDR is auto-merge, so no computer is necessary. If you do the math, it is a lot cheaper compared to buying a dedicated computer to do all the stitching and color grading. So it is a different approach. As an artist like myself, I might want the best quality to go with the Z1 or the Qoocam AK, but as a business, efficiency and profit margin are what you should care about. If you can finish hundreds of 8K to 60 photos in a day, you will kill all your competitors and still save a lot of money. So, which one are you? Artist or business savvy? Comment below and let me know. Swiftbird AK Cloud Live Streaming Solution. The AK Cloud Live Streaming without a PC is the reason why I get this camera. Live Streaming 360 is one of the easiest ways to make money with 360 technology. I did one of the largest 360 live streaming around the world with Samsung VR and Special Olympics last year. And I can tell you, I wish I had the solution like this back then. It will save me and Olympics lots of money. You ask, there's no AK VR headset that can watch this. Well, there's one right here, the Skyworth V901. Check out this full review right here on Creator Up. And there will be more AK VR headset in 2020. Still under NDA, so I can't tell you anything just yet, but they are coming. With 5G network, it is possible to stream 60 megabit per second to get a decent 8K video with full immersion. We don't have 5G network in California just yet, but there is a direct integration between Skyworth AK with the Pilot One right here. So I can start a local stream right here and pipe the stream wirelessly without a computer directly into the Skyworth. And that is for sure the best live stream 360 quality I ever saw in a headset. Well, besides Kandao Obsidian, which easily can be $20,000 solution. This camera make it possible without me to go rob a bank.
This is gonna feel so good getting this thing off my chest.
Thank you for watching this initial review of the Labpano Pilot One. When the final firmware is released and the pilot tour is opened up to the public, I will make another in-depth review and tutorial of this camera, focused on helping virtual tour business like you on making money faster and still don't kill the artist inside you. So, don't forget to subscribe if you have not, and hit the notification bell. You will learn the best techniques, professional secrets on how to create immersive 360 content and experience for free with love. I don't believe in pulling my knowledge behind a paywall. I want to help as many people as possible do it in the right way and grow together as a community. So support me, share this video, smash the like button, and I will see you in the next video.